Hello everyone, welcome back to ChargerLAB. Today we're going to tear down another Anker 65W charger, the latest Anker PowerPort 3 2-port 65W charger. From the packaging, we can instantly find it's Anker's product. It contains the charger manual and certification. Let's take a look at the charger directly. The latest Anker PowerPort 3 series has a new black body. The output sides cover its silver gray. Anker has launched 4 chargers this year, including 30W, 45W, 65W of Anker Nano II, and they have all single USB-C. But this one has 2 USB-C ports. If you haven't seen the teardown of 45W and 65W of Anker Nano II, you can click the upper right corner to see it directly. Okay, let's see the design of this charger. There is an Anker logo, it adopts foldable pins, easy to carry. There are 2 USB-C ports can be used. It can support up to 65W when using single port, and will intelligently distribute the power when using dual port. Let's see the specification of the product. Model is A266. When using single port, both USB-C 1 and USB-C 2 can support up to 65W PD fast charging and 52W PBS fast charging. When using dual port, maximum output of USB-C 1 is 45W, maximum output of USB-C 2 is 20W. The total output power is still 65W. Designed by Anker Innovation Technology. The size of the charger is about 53.5, 52, and 28.8mm. The weight of the charger is about 137 grams. Compared with Apple 61W charger, this one is more compact. Compared with the previous Anker PowerPort 3 2-port 6W, the new one is also much smaller and more portable. Let's use ChargerLAB Power ZKT002 to test the USB-C 1 port. It supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCP, QC2, QC3, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2, PD3, PPS, and other protocols. It also shows 4 fixed PDOs, 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and 1 PPS PDO. We also tested the other USB-C port, which is the same result. When two devices need to charge at the same time, the maximum power displayed by USB-C 1 is 45W, the maximum power displayed by USB-C 2 is 20W. You can use it to charge the mobile phone and the laptop at the same time, suitable for business trips or traveling. Okay, after seeing the design and the performance, let's tear it down right now. After cutting the cover of the input side, we found there are lots of thermally conductive adhesive inside. PCB module cannot be taken out, so we can only continue to cut the shell. After taking out the internal PCB module, we really need to clean those thermally conductive adhesives firstly. Okay, that's it. Let's see the overall layout of the PCB, which is quite compact. The front side has some plug-in components. It adopts 4 small PCB to save space. The front side is divided into a high voltage part and low voltage part. It can be seen those two parts are relatively close. So there is an installation board in the middle. On the back, we can see the 2 main chips and some diodes. After our analysis, this charger is developed based on the combination of ACF switching power supply and step-down circuit. The current comes in from the AC and then go through the fuse, common mode choke, and safety capacitor. Then rectify the current by rectifier bridge, filter the current by capacitor and step down by transformer, and rectify and filter it again. Use the second step down to finally output. There are 2 rectifier bridges on the side. High voltage alternating current is transformed into high voltage direct current through the rectifier bridge. Then use the high voltage electrolytic capacitor for filtering. The 4 electrolytic capacitors adopt Yongming's small sized KCX series. 2 of them are placed on the motherboard. The other two are arranged horizontally on the side PCB. Three are 400 volts, 33 microfarad, and one is 400 volts, 22 microfarad. There is also an inductor with an outer insulating tube between the capacitors used for filtering. After filtering, the high voltage direct current will come to the transformer to step down. And that's all components on the front. The controller is on the back of the PCB. The master control chip adopts power integrations in a switch 4 series. Model is INN4075C. This is the latest highly integrated chip with built-in GaN from power integrations. It is applied to active clamp flyback architecture and can achieve the 0 volts switch of the main switch tube and reduce the temperature rise. Power integrations official data showed if this chip is used with power integrations on clamp 0 active clamp chip, it can recover leakage inductance energy and be up to 95% conversion efficiency. You know, most of the GaN chargers efficiency on the market is generally between 92% to 93%. So the high efficiency means the charger can be smaller. This is Power Integrations Clamp Zero chip. Model is CPZ1062M. It can form the ACF architecture with the master control chip. After the current is stepped down, it must be rectified again. The synchronous rectifier chip is integrated into the Power Integrations master control chip. The synchronous rectification moist tube should be behind this small PCB. Take it down and let's see. Yes, it comes from AOS. Two solid capacitors are used for low voltage filtering connected in parallel. The specifications for both are 25 volts, 470 microfarad. After rectification and filtering, the current can be used to charge. If it's a single port charger, it can be directly matched with the protocol chip to charge. But here is the dual port charger, so we need secondary step-down circuit. To remove those two secondary step-down circuits, they have the same layout and consists of a buck chip with two moist tube and an inductor. The buck chip comes from iSmartware SW3516H and has built-in step-down controller. It is used to control two moist tubes to achieve secondary step-down and can recognize different protocols. So, it is the first choice for multi-port fast charging products. Finally, two outputs need to be coordinated. Only this way, the power can be intelligently distributed. So, there is an MCU on the back of the motherboard, and the output strategy can be customized. So that's all for the teardown of Anker PowerPort 3 2-port 65W charger. It adopts the brand new design of Anker PowerPort 3 series, and it also keeps the small size, folding pins, dual USB-C, and multi-portable. Let the user experience move forward. The charger adopts the power chip from Power Integrations. The efficiency of ACF architecture can reach 95%, which is the guarantee for the small size. If you want to buy this charger, it'll need some time to see it on Amazon. Once there's an update, I'll put it in the description of the video. If you want to see other Anker charger and make the comparison, you can click the right side to see more. Oh, don't forget to subscribe to us if you want to see more and support us. I'll catch you guys the next time.